My name is Ouita Michel, and I'm a local chef. I own and operate Holly Hill Inn in Midway, Kentucky, Wallace Station, Windy Corner, Smithtown Seafood, Midway School Bakery, and soon to come, Honeywood Restaurant in Fritz Farm at the Summit. My mom died of lung cancer in 2014, and she had a special kind of lung cancer. She had never been a smoker, so she had never smoked even one cigarette in her life. But there's a kind of lung cancer that postmenopausal women can sometimes get. And she had the classic case of where she thought she had a cold and developed a cough and went in. Eventually they said, well, you might have some pneumonia, found some fluid in her lungs, biopsied that fluid, and it turned out she had stage 4 lung cancer. When that happens, my mom was a really vibrant young person. She was 67, but super, like, classic hippie mom. You know, we never ate, you know, we got carob in our Easter baskets, and, you know, very low fat, super healthy, first into the oat bran, first into flax seeds, all that kind of thing. So it was a shock. I always felt like she would outlive me, that she would beat whatever came her way. So as a family, we're just trying to grab, I'm reading every cancer cookbook there is on the market, making these special broths and smoothies, and I think I'm on the top of the world because it's all going down like great. She's feeling good. Her chemo is very effective. They take the chest drain out, and we had a fabulous Christmas. Shortly after that, her cough comes back, and she began to experience extreme nausea. In retrospect, what happened was her cancer moved to the brain. And I know that as a chef. I know that that's where you smell and where your taste and where your nausea triggers are, all in the same area. I know that. But I didn't put 2 and 2 together. I'm still thinking it has to do with her gut. So I'm trying to figure out how to feed her. And I think that was the most difficult period of my life. Was my mom was the person who taught me how to cook. And one of the most central things to my identity is this relationship that we have both had with food, and the way that we expressed our love for each other and for our family members was often through meal preparation and through cooking. And we did all that cooking together. I mean, we cooked from the time that I can remember being old enough to stand on a stool. We cooked every Thanksgiving together. We have cookie recipes in our family that go back 6 generations that are made up together every year. And for her, emotionally, not to be able to eat something that I had prepared for her to eat was extremely depressing and difficult for her. And it literally went like this. I would go over every single day. I would go through the aisles of the grocery store just like searching, what would she like? What's the right texture? You know, oh, this is too metallic. I already knew she was having a lot of metallic flavors. Just desperate to find the combination of foods that would appeal. Even odors began to make her feel nauseous, so I would prepare food and leave it out on the counter and fan it, literally fan it, and I would leave it out there for 45 minutes until I could discern no odor myself coming from the food, and then I would take it up to her. And it still would trigger nausea. And I've combed the internet, holistic stuff and non-holistic, and just trying to think about my chef brain and what could possibly work for her. I mean, we all know I think everyone at this point knows the end of the story is that no place for me to turn. I know everybody who has had someone they love die of cancer has gone through the same process. But for me, the interesting thing is the way they discern the efficacy of treatment in oncology is by asking you a series of questions when you're a patient. Have you gotten out of bed? Have you taken a walk? You know, so it's this quality of life questions like, how active are you? And I know there's a medical term for it. It took months for me to realize that the reason her oncologist was asking her these questions was to figure out whether or not the cancer treatments were working. I knew that her nutrition was key to giving the right answers to these questions, and so to me then it became like, well, then the nutrition is the key to the treatment. Fast forward, my mom passed away, and we got fantastic treatment. You know, we got fantastic treatment at Markey, and the people were fantastic. So these things, these observations that I have are in retrospect, and they're a way for me to find a place in how to help people in my mom's memory.